Elon Musk has made headlines a lot this week, you know, one for his Twitter deal kind of falling apart, two for announcing that he's now going to start voting for Republicans after voting for Democrats because Democrats are just so darn mean. They used to be the party of kindness, he says, but now they're not, so he's totally going with the Capitol Riot Party because apparently they're nicer. And yesterday, the truth really came out. We found out why Elon Musk has been trying to trash Democrats. We found out why Elon Musk has been tweeting out cryptic messages that the political attacks on me are only going to get worse in the coming months, because Elon Musk knew that a story was about to break. And break it did. The story is that a SpaceX flight attendant in 2016 alleged that she was sexually harassed and propositioned by Mr. Musk on a flight to London, where she was giving him a massage on the plane. He exposed his erect penis to her and was rubbing her thigh, propositioning her for an erotic massage, and allegedly, again, offered to buy her a horse if she went through with his requests. And we know this because one of the friends of the flight attendant, who wrote a sworn statement to a lawyer about what she had heard from her friend, has now been revealed to the public. Have to be a little clear here. No charges were ever filed, okay? All of this is alleged. But here's more to the story. In 2018, 2 years after the incident, the flight attendant, according to these records, basically was felt like she was being retaliated against, right? Her hours were being cut for the last 2 years after she denied Musk's request. She wasn't advancing in the company. She felt her opportunities had been diminished or outright revoked because she didn't go through with Elon Musk's requests. So she goes to a California lawyer. She tells them what happened, and of course, that's where the friend writes out the declaration, gives it to the attorney. So the attorney goes to SpaceX. SpaceX says, okay, listen, we're going to sit down with a mediator. And they did. This was not an official arbitration. It was just a mediator. Elon Musk was personally there during this, you know, impromptu mediation. And they agreed on paying the flight attendant a $250,000 severance on the condition that she sign an NDA, non-disclosure agreement, along with a non-disparagement agreement. Meaning, one, non-disclosure, you can't tell anybody what he allegedly did. And two, you also can't go out there and talk bad about our company. That's the non-disparagement clause. She signed the documents. The friend, with her sworn declaration, approached the lawyer recently and said, can I release my declaration? And the lawyer said, well, you didn't sign an NDA, so technically you can, but understand this could put your friend, you know, in a bad spot. But the friend felt that this was the time to tell the story. It had been silent for too long. You know, the payment did happen. We know the payment happened. This former flight attendant got $250,000. She's not allowed to explain what happened. And she was, you know, released from the company. But as far as this behavior alleged to have happened from Elon Musk, this is a big deal. And to be clear, this is also the first time anybody has come forward with these kind of allegations against Musk. So, you know, it's not building on a pattern of behavior. This is allegedly the first time, at least that we know of. But Musk knew the story was going to break because they reached out to him for comment and he requested, you know, give me more time to make a comment. And then he just never got back with him, so they finally released the story. But he knew the story was coming, which is why he started coming out this week talking about, oh, the political hits against me are going to get so bad. But rather than actually address the story, he decided to go ahead and try to muddy the waters on Twitter, which isn't exactly the actions of somebody who's got nothing to hide, in my opinion. Right? I wasn't there. I don't know what happened. Again, all of this is just alleged. But Musk's behavior isn't exactly what you would expect from someone who allegedly has nothing to hide.
Hey everyone, you know what this is. It's the end screen where I'm supposed to beg you to like, comment, share, and subscribe for more content from Ring of Fire. But what I really want to do is ask you to consider becoming a member for more exclusive content and perks, including early access videos and exclusive videos. Check out the link in the description or go to youtube.com/theringoffire/membership.